all round very nice player. And this is what makes Rayner scary. He can...
to fall. Heart is singing like a cannonball. Baby, kill it, what you waiting for? We'll be right back. here if I was the first to fall. Heart is singing like a cannonball. Baby, kill it, what you waiting for? We'll be right back. fast to fall. Heart is singing like a can of bubble. Baby, kill it, what you waiting for? We'll be right back.
All right, everybody. Can everyone hear me okay? All right. So today, I'm actually off today, so I have plenty of time to kind of can't hear me in server. How about now? Okay. All right. Cool. All right, guys, so today I'm off. So I planned a little bit of a longer lesson, and by a little bit I mean like 2 to 3 times as long as Wednesday. So I hope you guys are ready. Make sure you got your water or tea or whatever you want. Got your art supplies, and that you're ready to go. So today we're gonna be watching a video from Proko on gesture drawings. It's about 10 minutes long. Then we're going to actually do some gesture drawings for about 10 minutes. We're going to do 30-second figures, or 30-second gestures. Figure drawing explanation. I found a video that was pretty okay. It's about 5 minutes long on this guy's journey through figure drawing. And then we're going to do a draw this live model video drawing. Those are usually about 60 seconds. Then we're going to take a little break. Then we're going to come back, and I found a pretty cool artist that we're going to reference. We're going to reference 10 of their paintings at 4 minutes each. And we're going to take a little bit of a break, and then we can decide what we want to do from there. Dope.
Hey there, my name is Sam Mikopenko. Thanks.
Let me fix something real quick. I don't know if you guys will be able to hear it on stream, but maybe. If not, then I can turn up my mic and do it that way.
Okay, so the stream apparently.
Thanks for watching,
I can't go in because it's got like a max number of viewers. So.
Yeah. Use the Twitch.
Wait, there's a Twitch?
Yeah, I just posted the Twitch again in Classroom 2 chat. And you should be able to hear the video on there. Not that.
Alright, thank you.
I don't care which one you use, but you'll be able to hear the video on there.
This is the first figure drawing video, and it's probably one of the most important. In this lesson, I'll be covering gesture.
I don't hear it.
Say again.
What the butt munch is gesture anyway? Gesture, rhythm, motion, action, flow. Yeah, these are all words that are used interchangeably, and they basically mean the same thing.
Yeah, I can't hear it.
They all refer to the movement.
Hold on, let me fix that. Give me a second.
It's not the con.
All right, if you cannot hear it after this, you just have to go to the Twitch.
Contours are the forms or the tones. It's the movement that connects the contours, forms, and tones. For example, if you have 3 balls, the gesture here would be a C curve that describes the relationship of these balls. This would be the contour, but this is the gesture. It's simple to understand, but difficult to put into practice when you're actually drawing a human figure. We're so tempted to draw the details of the anatomy and all the little bumps of the contour because we think the details will make our drawing look better. But the reality is, the detail is nothing without the gesture. You might accidentally get some gesture while you're copying the contours, but I don't like to rely on accidents. A better approach would be to practice finding the gesture of the figure so many times that it becomes second nature. Quick sketch is a common exercise in art school that involves drawing the model from life within a few minutes. A typical quick sketch lesson lasts 2 to 3 hours, with poses ranging from 30 seconds to 10 minutes per pose. Gesture is the primary concern. Doing this exercise will train you to see the gesture immediately. You can feel it. Then you'll be able to design the details to complement the gesture instead of copying details randomly. Your journey of mastering QuickSketch will be a long but exciting one. There's a lot to learn, and every time you learn something new, your sketches will show improvement. During a normal session, you'll finish anywhere from 25 to 100 drawings. Think about that. You're drawing the human figure up to 100 times within a few hours. If you do this on a regular basis, you're gonna get better. The best thing about it is it's actually fun, if you don't stress over it. In this video, I'll go over all the concepts you need to know for a successful QuickSketch drawing that focuses completely on gesture. In future videos, I'll build onto that and introduce additional concepts, all of which come together. And in the end, with enough practice, you can use all these concepts to produce a completed QuickSketch drawing in 5 to 10 minutes. Gesture is in everything, not just a figure. It's in the clouds, waves, trees, mountains. So basically, gesture is in everything around us. It's an approach to drawing that you can use to draw anything. Use gesture to tell a story by capturing the body language. We use our whole body, not just words, to communicate ideas and emotions. This is what the gesture should capture. What is the person doing? What is he feeling? What did he just do? Or what is he going to do? This could be told through just a few lines, which the viewer will recognize as the body and can identify the emotions the person is feeling, just like we can intuitively identify emotions of the people around us. It's a good idea to exaggerate the pose to tell a better story. As you become more skilled in exaggerating, you'll also improve in capturing the subtleties. You're probably thinking, Stan, is this another April Fool's joke? Are you drawing another stick figure? Nope, don't think of it as a stick figure, because that could make your drawing stiff. They're not sticks. They're not straight lines. They're action lines. Observe the pose and analyze the movement. It's more about how it feels rather than how it looks. Later, we will add more structure to these drawings to make the figures feel more solid and real. So for those of you that don't find this inspiring and are thinking, I don't want my people to look like spaghetti, remember that this is not meant to be as a finished drawing. It's an exercise to practice a concept. You're training your mind to see rhythm in everything you draw. You're training your mind to consider more than just the contours when you're drawing shape. It's an important concept that needs to be intuitive. In all these drawings that you're seeing now, the element of gesture was applied to the anatomy to make the figure dynamic. Let's go over some important concepts to remember while practicing your gesture drawings. The longest axis. When you look at a form and try to find the gesture, look at its longest axis. Going down the length of the torso, down the length of the leg, down the length of the arm. It's in the longest axis of each form where you'll find the fluid motion from one form to the next. CSI. To eliminate unnecessary information and to capture that gesture, the lines you use should be simple. Don't use anything more complicated than a C-curve, S-curve, or straight. You can use combinations of these curves as you move down the figure, but attempt to do it in as few lines as possible using the simplest lines, C, S, or I. Line of action. Start by finding the longest action line of the body. Try to find a curve that could connect the head to the toes. Not all poses can be efficiently described with one long line that connects the head to the toes. But there is always one main line that shows a directional flow of the pose. This is called the line of action. In this pose, the line of action would be a C-curve, showing the major flow from the torso to the legs. But this doesn't tell the whole story, so this pose would need to be broken up into more parts. I think this sharp turn in the hips is important, so describing it with a soft curve isn't right. In this case, I would use a combination of a C-curve for the torso and S-curves for the legs. Relaxed and tense curves. The bendiness of the curve you use changes how the gesture feels. a longer fluid curve feels relaxed and moves the eye quickly through that flow. As you start to bend that curve more, you show more energy and more tension in the gesture. Eventually, when it's bent far enough, you can use a zigzag. A zigzag indicates tension, sharp corners, very sudden changes in the movement. Nature presents this very well with water. When the water is calm, the waves flow in an S-curve rhythm. During a storm, when there's more energy in the water, the waves flow in a zigzag pattern. So when you want to create tension, think zigzag. When you want to show something is relaxed, use a flowing curve. The asymmetry of the body. Consider the asymmetrical aspect of the body from the side. The forms alternate in angle from head, rib cage, pelvis, upper leg, and lower leg. This causes alternating C curves that lead the eye through the body, like a river flowing through a stream. The tendency for us is to make things symmetrical, but this stiffens the gesture and makes the figure look like a snowman. Next week, I'll show some examples of gesture quick sketches and guide you step by step through the process. But I suggest you attempt to practice these concepts on your own before watching the step-by-step video next week. You'll have an idea of what it's like and will be able to pull more information from it because you know what to look for. You'll have questions you can focus on, and you can compare what you did with what I do. If you need reference photos, I have some pose file sets you can get at proco.com/poses. If you want a more detailed explanation and plenty... Oh, come on! Really? If you want a more detailed explanation, plenty of examples, and additional videos, go to proco.com/figure. For every free video that I post during this figure series, I'm going to post additional premium videos on proco.com. So, go check it out. If you like this video...
Before you give him money, just make sure you know about the kangaroo. Alright. Does anyone have any questions about that? Okay, you want to see the kangaroo?
Drawing from imagination is one of the last things you're going to learn, and it's hard. Okay, there's a box. Let's be a little more creative. What do I know about boxes? A jack-in-box. I'm going to draw a dog. I'm going to draw a cartoon dog. Okay. Whatever. Doesn't matter. Let's say it's a ball. A kangaroo. Well, okay. Anyway, you guys get the idea. If I had a better idea in my mind, maybe this would be a lot cooler. You can also start by drawing blobs. You don't even have to think about perspective. Now, I don't really like that. I can cut into it. Okay, kind of start with a blob like that. We're going to not post this demo on YouTube as a replay right away. I'm going to edit it down to a quicker version, I think. Don't take my word for that. But just saying, don't expect to see a replay of it right away. You know, don't make the same mistake. Don't wait 10 years to start.
All right. So I'm not going to take any questions about that one other than it happened. Dude, it is art. All right. Well, now that we got that out of the way, we're going to... All right, now that you guys are a little bit loosened up, we're gonna do some line of action. I think we're gonna do both male and female today. Actually, no, our model for the video is female, so we'll do a female. That's cool. So we're gonna be trying to apply what Proco taught us in this video that we just watched. kangaroos aside, ignore that. That's just a meme, all right, guys? This is not serious. I'm going to set a timer. And we're going to go. I'm gonna put on some music. If it's too loud, you guys tell me. My bad.
Thank you.
All right, y'all, we're done with that. How'd you guys like that? You can feel free to share some of your work in the chat. Yeah, I hope you hated it, and I hope it was really hard. Okay, good. Do you guys know why I choose to use 30 seconds instead of a minute? No, not because I hate you. Exactly. I want you to be focused and panicking at the same time. Because... yeah. Basically, I want you guys to struggle because people usually tend to do better at things when they feel like they're in some kind of threat. So, I mean, that's just my personal philosophy. If you guys hate it, whatever. Oh, those are good, Spudster. Not to call you out or anything, but that's a good gesture right there. A lot of these are really good, guys. I apologize. I had to turn down my sensitivity for my mic, so you're going to hear everything. All right, so next is next video. Guy talking about gesture, or not gesture drawing, but figure drawing. So we're using gesture as like sort of a warm-up in this class. Every time I do a figure drawing class, we're going to do gesture drawing first, just to kind of get your blood flowing and your art brain thinking. So we're gonna watch this real quick.
So after a year of figure drawing, I'm finally starting to have a good time. And although I'm not the best at figure drawing, I'm not like super good, I've gotten to the point where I don't think I super suck anymore. Whereas before, when I first started, I was not having a good time. I would see the model, try draw the model, and I would fail miserably. The gap between the model and the expectation of what I could draw was so large. So in this video, I want to guide a younger version of me on mistakes not to have
good
done
job,
during the learning process, and all the things that I felt gave me a new level up in learning figure drawing. The first biggest thing that helped me was starting
Vitor,
to draw.
Good job too.
And I know
Mysterio,
this may sound
awesome.
Basic, but I had never
Buddha.
Tried figure drawing seriously before.
All you guys.
So going to a class forced me to draw figures and to actually try. The homework was 20 figures a week, and that was enough to get the ball rolling, pencil to paper, solidifying and highlighting that I can't draw the figure, even if I tried. And because doing more drawings became a constant, I obviously wanted to reduce my feeling of sucking, and that gave me the motivation for figuring out how to draw better. Which leads me to my second point, learning 3D anatomy. And this point is contested depending on the school of thought you're in, but for me, this is what helped the most. Specifically, Kirk Shimoto's analytical figure drawing class. I've got a video on it, but essentially, the human is broken down into smaller objects, and you learn how to construct each piece of anatomy. You see an arm, you know how to draw an arm, draw the arm. My third level up is definitely my biggest level up. It's the difference from this to this. And it's just me literally holding my pencil differently and trying to do a good drawing. Previously, I was holding my pencil like this and just routinely thinking about the method I was taught to use. But after watching this video and I saw the way Watts people draw, my mind was blown. Screw constructing everything, I thought. Just draw whatever I want, whenever, for the benefit of trying to do my best. And that was it. There wasn't necessarily new instruction, it was just a mindset change.
The fourth idea of shading and line weight is something I'm currently working on. Previous to any knowledge, you can see my shading to be extremely flat and lifeless. And this wasn't to say I didn't understand the physics of, because I...
Don't try this today unless you know you can. I'm not saying, like, don't try it ever. I'm just saying today we're going to be focusing more on the actual makeup and physique, not physique, the construction of the person, not so much the shading. Some of y'all can do it, but we're only going to have 60 seconds, so keep that in mind.
I definitely knew how to run the...
Say again? If you want to focus on that, you can, but for the newer people, we're going to be focusing on the construction and the anatomy of the figure.
The spheres. The way I learned basic rendering was through a combination of Will Weston and Ramon Hurtado. Will showed me through rendering bones. Core shadow is a soft dark line, whereas drop shadows are hard dark lines. And although I got the concept mentally, I didn't have enough practice with the idea yet, which is where taking classes with Ramon really helped. He introduced me to these stumps that allow for full tonal images relatively quickly. And it's been this repeated exposure and desensitization on doing value that's helped me to recently add it to my quick sketch figure drawing. Faces. I still haven't figured this out yet, but I've had an evolution in it, and that was solely from watching Ramon's advanced head figure construction video. And although my heads still look like garbage, I think they're usually in the realm of not extremely repulsive, please don't look. Like, I can pull out a head right now, and it could be a lot worse. And so those are the five biggest evolutions I've had during my year. And although I could definitely improve upon my path, I think I've done pretty okay. I only actually ever completed 7 to 9 of these drawing pads, which in the grand scheme of things, if I were to go ham, isn't that much. I've been
only,
working
guys,
full-time
he
job,
only did
I
nine
exercise
of those.
Every day and cook my meals. I didn't spend all day drawing the figure or anything. At the same time, I didn't spend no time drawing the figure. Every week I at least did one figure drawing session. So all in all, if Passmark were to know what Feature Mark knows now, I think I could probably reach the same level of skill in like 4 to 6 months. So like half the time or less than half the time. Nonetheless, I think the process of learning figures or is knowing what type of figures you want to do. And I definitely did not know that then, and I still don't really know that now. So art, like everything else, is definitely a journey, it's a discovery process, and I'm very grateful for everything that I've had the opportunity to learn and do. But yeah, that pretty much covers it. If you're interested, these are all the classes that I did. I don't think I'm the sum of these classes, but yeah, maybe that might help you. And thanks for watching, guys. I hope you have a lovely day or night, wherever you...
Alright, guys. He said he only did 9. So obviously that's a bad thing, right? So I'm going to want 18 by tomorrow morning. Alright? JK. That's quite a lot. For someone who doesn't draw every single day, that's a lot. Okay, so we're going to be moving on to this. I'm going to mute it and play some music. And set a timer. If you're confident enough in your sketching abilities to get done with the form and then shadow, you can do it. But if you're new, like new and you know who you are, don't worry about it. Cool? Okay. Yeah, sure. Let me do this. Okay, so let's say we got a person, right? And they're just kind of hanging out, got their arms crossed above their head.
We're going to show that with the gesture, if we were gesture drawing. Or even if we're figuring drawing, we can start with this too. So when you start to build up the form, there's some things to keep in mind. You've got pelvis, which is a sphere, or not a sphere, it's more like a cone, kind of. It's a complex shape. And then you've got the rib cage. Then you got all the goop in here, which is going to be filling out the stomach. And then, of course, we have our legs and the feetsies. So whenever you get your gesture or your stick figure or whatever you use, I use like kind of a stick figure with some orbs to represent the muscles and the shoulders. And then you just kind of build onto it. Like, you know that there's going to be a bicep here if you studied it. You know that there's going to be muscles here that connect the shoulder to the chest right here. Okay. And then you're going to know that there's biceps, forearms. You're going to have a chin. And you're just going to kind of build it up. This is how I do it. If you have a different way to do it, if you use another artists, like older artist style, like figure drawing for all it's worth, or Bridgman, or whoever, and you want to do that, do that. This is me, how I personally do it. Just because for me, it's easier to visualize where everything's at. Any more? Does that answer your question, or? All right. I'm not going to tell you that. But each pose will have its own timer on the video. And then after this is a break.
Somebody needs to turn on their push to talk. To put on push to talk big time, man. Thank you. music is too loud? Okay. I'll turn it down.
Thank you. this is saying then is that just as you don't know how you manage to be conscious, how you manage to grow and shape this body of yours, that doesn't mean to say that you're not doing it. Equally, you don't know how the universe shines the stars, constellates the constellation, and galactifies the galaxies. You don't know. But that doesn't mean to say that you aren't doing it in just the same way as you're breathing without knowing how you breathe.
my music, you know what I'm saying? I want people to feel what I feel. I want them to feel that energy that I, whatever it was. Yeah, that's all it is. Because I make it straight from the heart. So it's like, to be taken for anything else is crazy to me.
Thank you.
Hold up, did I hear someone say burnout? You don't have enough fuel in the tank? Bruh, alright, here's what we're gonna do, okay? We're gonna switch up the pace a little bit. And I'm gonna add 5 minutes to the timer.
Kings and top hats with the doorman. From that moment, you'll be out of place and under duress. I'm wrecking this evening already and loving every minute of it, ruining this banquet for the mildly inspiring end. Please leave all overcoats, kings and top hats with the doorman.
One more, let's keep going. 2 minutes.
Accentuating up white two stripes, the wall. Everything goes according to plan. Open your camp, never look better, you can't stand it. Cause it takes snow under your breath, you're reading lips with the heat. I'll come from down to earth and our love is cancer. Never look better and you can't stand it.
Next is a trip to the ladies' room in vain, and I pushed All right, everybody. That's enough of that. I hope you all were sufficiently challenged. We're going to take a break. A 10-minute break. No music or anything. We're just going to... Well, actually, I'll play some of the music I made in the past. Play some music I made in the past, and then we'll be back in 10 minutes, okay? Say again. Oh, okay. My bad. Is this way of doing it egregious or something? Okay. Well, we'll use the bot when we come back.
All right, everybody. What I'm going to do is, if you don't want music, the Discord stream won't have it. And if you do want music, the Twitch stream will. And if for some reason you can't watch the Discord stream, I'm sorry, if you can't watch Discord and you can watch Twitch, you can just mute the Twitch and leave me unmuted on here. That should work.
Actually, that sounds like a really good idea.
Thank you. Let's do it that way. Sorry, guys. Well, you can still listen to the music. It'll just be on Twitch. Yo, Evie, I can sing that whole song. I have it memorized from high school.
How did I just notice what the stretch your body list says?
You don't pay attention.
SMH, bad student.
I guess I just outed myself.
Exposed.
You gotta stretch your body.
Alright, y'all. 10-minute break's over. Let's get back to it. Got a little bit more to do today before we take another break. It's not gonna be as long until the next break this time. And then we're gonna figure out what to do from there. So this will be a 40-minute exercise. We have 4 minutes on each image, and what we want to do is we want to try to replicate the characters in the images. And if you want to get fancy, you got 4 minutes, so you're free to do that.
Okay.
So are we focusing on detail and such?
And focus on what's important for you.
Mm-hmm.
This is reference drawing. It's not technically gesture or figure drawing, but we're going to use elements of both to get our, to copy the image that you're going to see.
So it's like drawing it while trying to break down the body?
Yeah.
Like a combination.
Yeah, combination of all the things we've done today, plus anything else you may have done that you might find helpful. Yes, you'll have the reference here in a sec. I'm just making sure there's no more questions.
So how many minutes per reference?
4.
4 minutes.
4 minutes.
Good.
Okay. Yep, reference drawing. Replicate as much as you can. Oops.
Can you tell us when it's like a minute left?
When it's what? A minute left?
Yeah.
Okay. Got about a minute left. Minute. 1 minute. I'm gonna give you guys a minute to set your layers up if you need to change layers. Alright, about to go on the next one. Actually, I don't even play League of Legends. I played in Alpha and I haven't played since. I just like this artist.
What's the name of this artist again?
Look at it in a minute, I'll tell you. By the way, you get 20 seconds left on this one.
Mm-hmm, 20 seconds.
All right, man. See ya. Thanks for coming to class. Bye. About a minute left. Five seconds. 2-minute warning. One minute. 45 seconds. Oh, yeah, that's the one. I'm sorry, guys. I completely forgot. I got caught up in what I was doing. 45 second warning, by the way. Thank you. This is the last one, by the way. Alright, Peachy. See you next time. This is a little bit longer class than normal because I have off today, so if you guys come back to my class in the future, it won't always be this long or this hardcore. About 2 minutes and 30 seconds left. We're gonna take a break after this one, 1 minute warning, and then we're gonna do one more exercise, which you guys are gonna pick it. Monday, Wednesday, Friday, comical. And for any of you guys, I have a tip jar on my Twitch, if you are so inclined. I'm not asking, I'm just telling you it's there. Alright, you got 1 second left. Time for a break. Everybody stretch legs. Get some blood flowing.
お待ちください。 まもなく1番線後電車が使いたいします。危ないですから黄色い線路内側までお下がりください。 まもなく1番線に渋谷、新宿、お面行きが参ります。危ないですから黄色い線路内側までお下がりください。
Alright, 2 minutes left on break. Make sure you got some water in you and stretch around a little bit. Alright guys, we need to start talking about what we want to do next.
Learning.
Learning, okay. It's very astute.
Thank you.
Serve our sky overlords.
That's funny you say that.
The cloud people!
If we could learn how to summon Cthulhu, that'd be amazing.
Sky people don't associate with Cthulhu.
Damn.
Maybe Thumbless sketches? I don't know.
They control the clouds. They put chemicals in the water that turn the fucking fogs gay.
Alright now. Let's not get political.
We shouldn't have gone to Vietnam!
I think one of the stream, Ethan Becker, I think Cynix says something that you need some. Once you, if you keep like drawing you once, then like your texture knowledge might making artists a little bit very enjoyable. I think Cynix was trying to say is kind of true to me.
Hands? You guys want to do hands?
Texture, I guess.
I'd say we could do the beam, but I don't know the beam. I mean, I've done it before, but I couldn't teach you about it.
I think I would try hands, because that's actually my most weakest spot in the body.
Okay.
Hands will be fun. I like drawing hands.
That's what you guys want?
I don't really like drawing hands. I don't like them a lot.
Is push to talk on?
A lot. No.
Okay.
But yeah. Give me the chicken fingies. Let's draw chicken fingies.
Yeah.
Heck yeah.
Dynamic chicken fingies.
Mm-hmm. With a side of honey mustard, if you will.
Oh, yeah.
Give me just a minute to pull up some references.
It's making me hungry. It's like 3 a.m. here.
It's 3 a.m. at your time right now?
You sound so cold, too.
Yes.
Real quick, before we start this next one, I want to share some feedback with you guys. Somebody liked the class on Wednesday. I hope some of you guys liked the class today. And Yeah. If you have feedback, feel free to PM it to me. Ideas, stuff you want to learn, and I'll research it before we start.
Thank you. Nice.
All right, how mean should I be?
Destroy us.
Hello.
All right. Let's calm down.
Eyes down and Pegasus.
We're gonna do 60 seconds.
Cool down here.
We're gonna do 60 seconds on hands.
Give us 2 seconds for each hand.
No, that's not an option. I mean, it is an option. I could just do that, but I'm not gonna. Go thick as life. I said PM me. I can't go back and read the chat all the time, man. Alright. 60 seconds. Hands. We're gonna do... We'll do 10 minutes of hands, and then we'll do 10 minutes of feet. Cool?
Mm-hmm. Sounds good.
Okay.
Epic.
Does anyone need any help right now? If you do it, speak up so that we can get you.
Me, please. So we can.
So what's going on?
I can't see the screen.
You cannot see the
screen.
I'm trying
to simplify the whole hunt.
It's just loading.
Are you on the Twitch?
Because I don't know any techniques that I could try to draw with hunt.
Break them down into shapes. Try to break it down into squares, circles, stuff like that. Try that. Boxes. Do you want me to show you right now? Alright, I'm gonna pause this one. I'm just gonna show an example real quick for someone who just asked, okay? So we have this hand. Let me bring up my tablet. Just a second. Okay, so we have a hand. We know that the arm is a cylinder, basically. Alright, so we have our cylinder. You don't have to draw that as part of a hand drawing, but if you want to, cool. So we have the joint. And then you can break it down like this and get the general shape. right? And you can kind of tell that this is sort of a oval sort of shape, right? And then you can break down the fingers into boxes or squares, whichever you prefer. I like boxes for hands, but sometimes I get lazy. And just keep in mind the planes of the object that you're looking at. So if you want to break it down in a semi-easy way, this is how I would go about it. Okay? Does that answer your question? Alright, well, I'm going to continue the timer.
real quick. Don't you ever draw without a blank.
Wait, what did you say?
I said, don't you ever draw without a blank. Type in the chat your answer. That's it for hands. We'll finish this one out. Yeah, Wisteria. That's my saint, though. That's not Ethan's. Alright, done with hands. Gonna hit up some feet. Starting timer now. Now, if you want me to teach you how to break down a foot, I can do that real quick. Should I do that?
Yes, please.
Yes, please.
Alright.
Yes.
Okay. That's not a very good example. Well, it's fine. It's fine. We'll just go with it. Okay. Alright. So, the foot, essentially, is the ball of your foot. That attaches to the heel. There's a tendon in here. Don't think about that too hard. Also, don't rip it ever. That sucks. Alright. So, at the ball of your foot, you're going to have the pad of the foot. Okay. It's basically a flat plane, essentially. It can curve. It does curve. And then, up here, you're going to have your big toe joint. And you're going to have your knuckle for that toe joint. And you come around, you got some more tendons in the front that attach to your muscles on your shins. You got a big ankle bone there. Then you just kind of block in your shapes for the toes. Oops. I'm going to go back. But obviously, we don't want to draw this plane right here, if we can help it. We just want to imply it, because otherwise that makes it look like a platypus or something. Everybody good?
Anything?
Okay. Yes, sir. This is double hard because there's two of them.
Get good.
Oh.
I'm just being a little cranky. You're good. You'll do fine.
I mean, that's what I'm here for. Getting good.
Also, there's a class coming up here in... I think an hour or two? For...
It's like an hour and a half, 2:30 my time specifically.
A figure workshop. No, that's not the right one. An animation. Maybe? I don't know. We'll see.
Yeah, animation.
Well, you guys will be real good in that class if it's a daytime for you guys, because you'll be nice and warmed up.
Mm-hmm. The fear is still fresh within me.
Eventually, you just get used to it.
Well, I'm back.
This made me realize how I do not draw feet often at all.
Well, that's where the money's at, so you gotta learn fast.
Gotta pay these bills.
Exactly.
Just keep going.
Do you have to draw both feet, or you can just draw one of them?
However many you can do in 60 seconds.
Draw all 10 feet.
All 10 feet.
The sky people have 4 feet. 4 feet per leg, so you know, just be ready. They're gonna want self portraits.
Oh no.
In their image, you know?
Yeah. Statues, portraits,
how
plaques.
How do you know this information?
Dude, I was in the Air Force. There's shit I can't tell you.
I saw them.
I will pay you in Bitcoin to tell me.
Are you denying basic radar service?
No, I just want more information.
Are you denying
basic
radar service?
I just want to know more about his feet.
No.
Look, do you have pictures?
Are you denying basic radar service?
No, I just want pictures.
Are you denying basic radar service?
Specifically, do you have pictures of the 4 feet? I would like to see the feet.
Are you denying basic radar service?
The cloud people got him. Run.
Oh boy, this... Okay.
Question, we have to make them details or just the shapes?
Hold on, let me pause my music. I couldn't hear what you said, but can you speak up a bit?
Do we have to render the feet completely or just the major shapes?
Major shapes, then do whatever you want to do after that.
Okay, thank you.
This guy needs one of those exfoliators, dude.
Need some lotion.
People pay top dollar for these feet.
For ashy feet.
Yeah.
That's why I don't like the Sonic fandom.
Oh no!
Please.
When I was like 8 and I was just starting to draw, DeviantArt was like a brand new thing. And I got my brand new Wacom Intuos 3 from my dad for Christmas.
Okay.
And I was looking for stuff to draw, and I found the Sonic fandom.
Oh, hell yeah.
And what's there that? It was.
Oh, boy.
What's that? You want to roll my feet?
big, stinky, smelly feet.
And you vowed never again.
In nasty yellow brown socks.
Mm-hmm. I'm about to throw up, Doug.
Well, your feet said that's where the money is.
Check them on radar.
What about radar? Are you denying basic radar service?
Oh my god.
Feet. When your feet so
stinky, I will cut you off this UHF channel. I'll do it. Your plane will go down and I won't know because I won't see you.
And I will destroy your bloodline.
Hey, real talk though, there really is aliens though. Just want to let you know that.
Yeah.
I never knew I could draw feet.
Alright, you got about 30 seconds left on this one. And that's going to be it, unless you guys want to do more.
Yeah.
More feet, please.
Okay. I never want to look at feet again.
Do like 5 more.
Oh, good.
I think after this I might go to sleep. It's like 3 a.m. 3:40.
Bro, go to sleep right now.
Then no, after the day. Right
now. Okay, all right. After this one.
Mm-hmm. I like the dedication, though. Good job.
Dude is on the grind.
Yeah.
Can't hate on that.
He hung
man is ascending.
Don't say that.
This is dark.
That's going to the sky, people.
He did.
Hey, real talk though, I can't tell you any more about the sky people. I've already said too much.
Oh god, this
they might be in the van on the way here already. Right?
The Air Force is on
the
way.
Do they have candy at least?
I'm not at liberty to discuss that information.
As long as
the fact that you say that makes me worried.
I signed an agreement with the Office of Special Investigations.
Oh my gosh.
So NDA, got you.
NDA, what? No.
They got 20 toes for you to suck on.
Oh my god.
Yeah.
Yo, they like it too.
No.
Hell yeah.
Oh no.
It's a form of greeting.
On the toes.
That is the worst thing I've ever heard.
The best way to say hello.
Gotta get right between the tendons.
Yeah. Gotta get all the tension out.
The tendon's the best part.
Guys, your homework is I'm actually gonna give you homework for this one. It's extra credit, okay? It's not graded, but it is extra credit.
Wow.
You get a personal good job from me if you do it.
I want a portrait of a sky person.
Alright.
Gotcha.
Gotcha.
Like actually.
So canonically the sky people have 4 sets of feet.
Yeah.
You'll tell us who's closest, right?
Yes.
And finally, I can serve my sky overlords by making something in their likeness. A dream come true.
We'll be blessed.
I bet they pay very well for their commissions.
Just like Kirby.
Yo, real talk though, they almost took over in 2012, but China couldn't get us to take away our people's guns fast enough, so they had to postpone it.
Oh my god.
Okay, so give me a breakdown of what's going on. What are you guys doing in here?
Finishing up some cooldown sheet reference photos.
Scrag.
Yeah, they're reference photos. That's what they are.
Yeah. I gotta get.
We're almost done, Costalong. I was just kind of shooting the breeze, joking around, talking about sky people.
Does anybody have the notes from the class today?
From the what?
What the hell, sky people? I just came
in. Notes.
Yeah.
I want to see what you guys were doing.
Yeah. In classroom chat 2, they've been posting feet for some reason. No, but they've been posting everything they've been doing, and I've got a slideshow from the lesson if you'd like it. Let me share it to you.
I want to draw these feet. Just a general overview is enough.
One more footsies.
Okay, so we did gestures. I just sent you the slides. We did gestures, then we did figure drawing, and then we did reference drawing, and now they wanted to do more reference on hands and feet, and then we're going to be done here in about a minute.
Give me a bit, I'm driving. So.
Oh, you're good.
Ooh, everyone's came out so nice.
Alright guys, this is the last one. I'm gonna take a break before the next class. Alright? Let's make it a good one.
Yes. I love how you guys break down yours. It looks really good. I like it.
What is this website you're on?
This is lineofaction.com. Do you want the link to it?
Yeah. I'll write it down. Oh, I'm sorry.
Did you put it in art resources?
I'm pretty sure it's already there, honestly.
Oh, is it? It's me.
All right, guys. That's it.
Oh my gosh.
Like I said, feedback in my PMs.
Here's my
feedback.
Feedback. What? Send you feed pics? Got you.
No, I don't want feet pics. I want sky people pics. It's extra credit.
Hell yeah. Yeah. Thank you for the class, Greg.
No problem.
Thank you.
You guys have a great rest of your day.
Bye, guys. I'm going to sleep right now.
All right. Good night. Have a good night.
Good night. Bye-bye.
Before you all leave, let me know how you felt about the class.
Yeah, let them know right now.
10 out of 10, coming back next time.
Which will be Monday, by the way, just so you know. Yes. Same time, but it's only going to be an hour.
Mm-hmm.
Needs more feet.
Considering I was basically only in here for the feet, 0 out of 10.
I'll consider it.
Yeah, 10 out of 10 for sure.
When did this class start?
How many people do we currently have in the classroom right now?
Say again?
How many people do we currently have in the open classroom right now?
We've lost a few, but we're at 48.
I think we were at 50 at some point.
We were actually at like 80 when we first started.
Oh, I only joined for the hands and feet.
Yeah, same.
We did about 2 hours before we started the hands and feet.
Okay. I'll have to make sure to join on time next time.
Yeah, so I run it on my lunch, but for y'all that's 5 p.m. GMT, or 1700, or for UK people at least. So, kind of around y'all's evening, I think.
Scrag, what's your background?
I'm a software engineer.
That's my favorite kind of artist.
I went to school for art, and then I dropped out after two semesters and joined the Air Force. And I just keep coming back to drawing. But I actually went to school for art and teaching. So this is kind of like my natural passion.
Thank you.
All right. Thanks, you guys.
Thank you. Bye-bye.
Have a great night.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Really nice class.
Thank you. See ya.
All right. Have a good one. Are you still driving Costa along?
Yeah, of course. It's going to be about 5-10 minutes before I get home. But I got to make a stop. I got to pick up some stamps.
Okay, are you wanting to talk to me when you get back or something? Or are you, you just checking us out?
Just seeing what you're doing. I do want to see the class itself. I want to see what you covered. I want to see what's going on.
Okay, well, I have it recorded on Twitch.